gazing into my crystal ball, I see people watching the video on how you came to be. Hi, my name is Nancy Parks, and today's video is on how I built my crystal ball stand. Please enjoy. Okay, we're back. I've been building shelves in my office and binding stuff, and I found my painter's palette. So we won't be messing up the cardboard anymore. I'm gonna take several coats of this. That's okay. Our spots are all dry, but I don't like the yellow, so we're going to repaint yellow. Our yellow dried out there. Acrylics. Go ahead and move on with the others. And maybe it'll be dry by the time we get back to it. So, red eye. Get some black out. Paint. Don't really need that much, but too late. I showed this in another video, but I used paper, and you'll see it there. We're going to use a nice fresh paper towel. paper stretches when it's wet. Then we lift it. Turn it over. Put down the third paper towel. Always line up on the one edge. Stretch through. Looks like I need to wet it. When it comes up, can be put right on top. Peel this up. Flip it over. You sit down and we're going to wet this. This time I have the number of paper towels. Last time I lost count and it only did it with 5. I had to go back and add one. I like 6, so I have 12 with singles. I like it. That's the number at 9, 12. You may like 14. You may like 5. It's a matter of choice. I like choices. I show how I do things. You may develop your own. Experimenting and playing. Popsicle sticks work in flattening. Anything that'll flatten and pick the stuff up and put it back down. Texture's okay on these for me. There is one brand. Oh boy, I had to hunt it down. I think it's Viva. Paper towels that don't have a texture of circles. When it dries, I draw my measurements if I'm doing a measured item. You can measure this way, that way. Every way you like. I cut off the thin. This one I put on barely dry. I need something that's not going to stick to my board, although my board is the same one I keep using. So it has a nice coat of dry Mod Podge on it. It's my drying board. Although I do need a little right here, but it will never stick. But no matter what you cut out, if you cut out a letter, you cut out a shape. Some people, I saw some beautiful Viking serpent drawings. I went, ooh, gave me ideas. But whatever you draw, if you don't have these all glued together, it'll come undone on you. So you want to get the ends down, you want to get the middle. Anyway, that's how I prep my raised surfaces and to raise it up. And while it's drying, I go back and check on it from time to time, make sure it doesn't dry to the board. So let me go put this to dry, come back when my paint is dry there, and I'm going to heat up my glue gun, so I can glue the cabochons on, and we'll start making rolls for the eyebrows and around the eye. This one is a black cabochon I had found first, but then I was able to find some rounded ones for this, and I like these better. So we'll come back and do that. dragon scales. That should keep the dragon scales that come up from sticking to it. And yet still hug it when it's a finished product. And that'll let me come down and I can paint both sides. And I took apart a blouse that I outgrew. Got some geedunk, I don't know if these. But I don't know if they'll go on top of the dragon scales, but I was hoping a few of the round ones could be put on. We'll see at the end. It goes right on that. So right now, I want to hang some large scales up and down before I work on the eyes. So they will probably be best. The finger. I make mistakes, I keep them. It gives it personality. Don't worry about it. Okay, I'm doing the eyes. And then we'll do the top, and then we'll fill in with small. So let's work on the eyes. I need a single sheet to make a roll. To make a roll, get your fingers wet. It needs to stop and dry because I am just knocking everything loose. So, I'm going to line everything back up. And let it dry because it has to dry. Or I'm just going to be lining things up and knocking things off. Putting things back on. That annoys me. So we shall come back and do some more rolling, eye rolling and stuff on camera. At least see one eye built. I also want to come back with a skewer and some Q-tips for cleaning the cabochon as you go. So you don't have to peel. monkey back for some more construction. I got some Q-tips for cleaning. As we go, it's easier to spend some time cleaning. It's easier to do as you go. I like the texture of the twists in the eye. Or in the twisted. I think that's about all cut by 100 yards. Now dragon eyes. Who knows what they look like? They come out of my head, come out of your head, and make it look the way you want it. You don't have to make it look the way mine look. Dragons are creatures of imagination. I'm not putting you here, I have to go get scissors. Should do any inside work. Even outside work. Yeah. I shall return. This one I wanted to go over the eye. Just give me a bit of time. Thank you. it just sit and dry. Come back, we're gonna finish up in here. Okay, I like to usually do two or twice in case you miss something the first time or want to see it again. And I'm going to do a dragon eye on a book, and your view for everything I do will be flat. So I'm not going to do it a second time in this video because this video is getting very extensive and long. So I will finish up this area, and I'm going to finish the other three eyes off camera, and come back when I'm ready to paint it. And I still haven't decided what color, although I'm going for a dark, mysterious color. So let's get this area done. We'll set it aside to dry, and I'll start on the dragon book. I have it set up to start the video because I already have the supplies here. So I'm going to put about three or four small dragon scales in this area. Some of this will help. Thank you. I want this a deep pit. This one too, when it's painted, you won't see that. But I won't leave it because this is a black eye. Or the dark blue eye. Yeah, that's a blue one. And you can repaint it white after we pick the color of the dragon. Okay. So we're back with the crystal ball stand. It fits nicely in the crystal ball. Nothing touches the ground. So this should look nice, dark, and mysterious for our fortune teller. We are ready to paint our crystal ball stand. Have it all painted brown. It meant to look kind of wooden. Start with the lighter colors. We'll clean the eyes, come back with some bling, and clean the ball. I think we'll safely put it in there now. I got some Mod Podge on the roof. We'll empty it out and get the total effect, and we'll finish it up. Okay, back with the bling. This looks great. The white, I don't care for down in there. So I gotta figure out a way to make this black and dark. It says I can just seal up a nice clear thing of water in it as a choice. That's what I want. My husband wants smoky. So we can, between the eyes and what eyebrows that are going in, we're going to put a stone. We'll put the glue on the back. sequins. I like the sequins better. I'll use sequins. So that's our crystal ball. We settled on those little candles in a piece of foam for just a little spark of light. So to recap, with a tuna can and some bottle caps, Mod Podge, paper towels, with some bling, you can make a wooden looking stand and some dragon eyes, and have a crystal ball for your fortune teller. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I did. Please like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Come visit me at nancyannparks.com. I have a Patreon set up for those who like to support the arts, but most of all, I'd like you to remember that you are loved.